Okay, hello everybody. Hi, and welcome to the BBC Learning English Live Friday Quiz. Now, I am Dylan, your host today. A big hello to anybody who's new here. Hello, and welcome back to anybody who joined us last week or the week before. Now, if you are just joining us or if you are coming back again, please tell me who you are, where you're from, your name, a little bit about yourself, and let's get to know each other. This is our third Friday quiz, and it is our film and TV special. And we've got some great quiz questions for you today. We've got vocabulary, phrasal verbs, celebrity quote, and we've got a very special mystery guest who I think you're going to be really happy to see. So I'll give you a clip. She's very popular with her followers and subscribers, so please stick around for that. Okay, so let's say hello. We've got Laura says hi from Argentina. Hi, Laura. Melanie says hi, teacher. Hi, Melanie. Saba, hi from Saudi. Hello from the UK. All right, so I'm going to go through a few rules, through a few guidelines to tell you about this, okay, about the plan for today. And the first thing you need to know is that there are eight questions. We're going to do eight questions, and we'll do the questions first, and we'll do the answers later. So stick around, questions first, and then we'll look at the answers at the end, okay? Thing number two that you need to know. It is just for fun. There are no prizes. It's a Friday. We want to relax. We want to have a good time, but there are no prizes. It's just for fun and to improve your English levels. Okay, so let's have a nice time together. Number three, please like, comment, and share. The more you get involved, the more beneficial it'll be for all of us, the more fun we'll have. And make sure you get comment. Tell me your answers. We love to know what you are thinking, what your answers are. So please be active. Invite your friends. So we're going to begin soon. Okay. If you want to invite any friends, now is the time to do it. So let's take a look at all the big hellos from the comments section. We've got Shay already. Thanks, Shady. Okay, we've got Manoj saying good evening. Hello. Hello, Salazar. You're an English teacher. We've got a lot of time because we're English teachers here too. We've got Ebtahal from Sudan. Big hello to you. All right, then. So we are nearly about to start. Okay, so we're just getting ready. So let me load up the first question for you. So here we go. It's round one of the BBC Learning English Live Friday Quiz. If you've just joined us, we're about to start, okay? This is the bell, which means it's time to move on to the new round. And please add your comments to the comments section. All right, then. If you are all ready, let's begin. Oop. Let's begin. Wow, what a start. Okay, so question number one is an idioms question. And we all love idioms, right? I think it's one of the most interesting part of the English language or languages in general. But which idiom means good luck for actors? So before a show or performance or before filming, people will say something to actors, which means good luck. I hope the show goes well. Do they say A, break a leg, B, jump the shark, or is it C, wait in the wings? Which of these three expressions, which of these three idioms means good luck for actors? What do you think? And let's take a look into the comments section. We've got Daniela says A, Manisha says C, lots and lots of people saying break a leg, a few people saying jump the shark. Let's have A, Rita. Okay, so lots and lots of A. So do Do you agree with the crowd or do you think something different? Let me know which idiom means good luck for actors. Okay, question number two. Round two. So if you have just joined us, this is the BBC Learning English Live Friday quiz. Please get involved. It's just for fun. Okay, so please let me know what you think the answer is to question two, which is a grammar question. Now, grammar is a really important part of English, obviously. And this is a classic type of sentence, type of grammar that we need to know. So what is the best film you have ever seen? B, have ever seen? Or C, I have seen? A, what is the best film you have ever seen? B, what is the best film you have ever seen? Or C, I have seen? Let's take a look at what you think in the comments. Carmen says A, Giuseppina says A, A, lots and lots of people saying A. Let's have a look. Past perfect, is that right? Kudi saying it's the past perfect. Is that correct, everybody? And please let me know, what is the best film you have seen? Learning English through films and movies and TV is a great way. So share your film recommendations with each other. Okay. Ding, 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 ding. On to round number three. Okay. This is the BBC Learning English Live Friday quiz. And we've got a special theme of movies today. Movies, film, TV. And we're on to question number three. Now, do you like scary films? If so, what do we call them? What do we call the type of films which are very scary, which are terrifying, which makes you go, when you watch them like this with your behind your hands? Is it A, a scarer, B, a thriller, or C, a horror? What do we call films that are very scary? Okay, we've got Kien says C, which horror. We've got Melanie saying it's a thriller. We've got, who else we got here? We've got Santiago saying B and C. Interesting answer. Okay, too easy, ready. Okay, well, keep going. I want to know your scores. Okay, so we'll be keeping count if it's too easy. Let's find out at the end, okay? So Igor says C as well. All right. On to round number four. So we are flying through the quiz and we are on to question number four. This is the BBC Learning English Live quiz. If you are just joining us, okay, we're on round four. Okay. So this, again, is a grammar question. And if you are looking to improve your grammar, be sure to check us out at bbclearningenglish.com. And we've got loads of grammar content and questions on our social media platforms. So that's Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube with BBC Learning English. But with this question, the next episode of my favorite show comes out Wednesday. At Wednesday, B, on Wednesday, or C, in Wednesday. At Wednesday, on Wednesday, in Wednesday. What do you think the correct answer could be? Okay, so let's take a look. Lots of people quite confident. We got at Sabawun saying at. Fadi is saying B. Maria is in B, 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 shouting it. Okay, very, very confident here. Okay, so if we are ready, we are going to move on to question number five. Okay, and question number five is going to have our special mystery guest. Now, would you like to guess who could that be? Who's our mystery guest today? Dun-da-da-da. Here we go. We've got a very special guest, Sian.
Hello, Dylan. Hi, everybody.
How are you?
I'm all right. My internet just cut out and I was worried I wasn't going to be able to join you, but I'm back just in time.
Phew.
Okay. You'd be all on your own with no mystery guest.
Yeah. I think everyone would be disappointed to see more of my face. So, there you are. Hey, how are you? How have you been? What have you been up to?
I've been doing lots of work today. So, I'm about to have 2 weeks off work. So, I'm trying to get everything finished before I go on holiday.
Perfect. I'm very jealous. What are your plans for your time off?
Well, you see, we're still in lockdown here, aren't we? So I don't have that many things I can do. So probably some runs, some walks, some cooking, tidying. Maybe I'll watch a few films.
I see you've done that because a nice link. I believe you've got a film question for us.
Have a film question for you. Are you ready for it?
We were born ready.
Okay, so my question is related to the Golden Globes, which took place this week. So when the actors arrive at an important award ceremony or event like this, what do they walk along when they arrive? Is it A, the red carpet? Is it B, the red path? Or is it C, the red line? So I'll repeat those options. A, the red carpet. B, the red path. Or C, the red line.
Okay, nice question. Okay, and I believe that this week we had a news review about the Golden Globes. So if anyone hasn't seen it, that goes out on Wednesday, on Tuesdays. So it's worth checking out after the show. It's a lovely one with Neil and Tom. Shan, what is your favourite film?
Oh, that's a difficult question. I don't really have a favourite. Now I just watch films once and move on. But when I was younger, I watched films over and over again. Things like Dirty Dancing, The Sound of Music, The Karate Kid. But yeah, nowadays, I watch a film and forget about it.
All classics. You mentioned all classics. Would you recommend watching films and TV shows to people learning a language?
Definitely. It's a great way to learn a language. You can watch with subtitles, without, watch a couple of times. It's a great way to learn new vocabulary, accents, etc.
Totally. Agree. So thanks for your question, Shan. I know you've got a few weeks off, but where and when can we see you next?
Well, we do grammar and vocabulary live lessons every Wednesday. So my next one will be at the end of March, but we have them every Wednesday. Charlotte will be here next Wednesday at 1:30 on Facebook and YouTube, and she's doing a lesson on using the present to talk about the future, which will be really interesting. So make sure you join her next Wednesday for that lesson.
Yeah, they're always great. I really enjoy the live lessons. They're fantastic.
They are. Okay. And so is your quiz, Dylan.
Thank you. All right, Shan, thank you for joining us. Enjoy your time off.
Excellent. Good luck and see you all very soon. Bye.
Okay. Bye, Shan. Oh, whoops. And that is Shan. So thank you very much, Shan. Melanie has asked, could you repeat the question, please? So I'm going to repeat the question one more time. So when there's a VIP or there's a celebrity or a star and they go to an awards ceremony, do they walk on A, the red carpet, B, the red path, or C, the red line? Okay, so that's the question. Red carpet, red path, red line. Thank you for your question, Melanie. Who else have we got? We've got Manisha says B, Sylvia saying the red carpet, Rahat saying the red carpet. Okay, so we got quite the variety of answers. Okay, Cody says A, but let's move on. Okay, whoops, that was round five. Okay, round six is the next question. Sorry, today it is playing up. It's racing ahead. All right. So this one is a quote by Samuel L. Jackson, which we looked at on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram on Saturday in our quote of the week, which goes out every Saturday morning. It's really nice. I highly recommend learning through these quotes. Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, bbclearnenglish.com. If you are just joining us, this is the BBC Learning English live quiz. And we're looking at what has Samuel L. Jackson said? I'm always look for an audience, looked for an audience, or looking for an audience. I'm always look for an audience, looked for an audience, or looking for an audience. Let's look at the comment section. They go very fast, your comments. Let's take a look. We've got Kaali saying C. We've got a big wave from Ashish. Hi. Angel or Angel is saying B, looked. So what does Samuel L. Jackson said? I'm always for an audience. So that is the question there. And let me know, what is your favorite Samuel L. Jackson film? I love Snakes on a Plane, if you have seen that. A very funny and enjoyable film. What's your favorite Samuel L. Jackson film? Okay, two more questions to go. We're going to do the questions first, and we'll be looking at the answers later. So stick around for the answers. They'll be coming up soon. Okay, so the BBC Learn English Live Friday quiz, round seven. Here we go. Aha, phrasal verb questions. And I know that lots of students find phrasal verbs quite tricky. Which phrasal verb means to perform a story as it were a play? Okay, so which phrasal verb means to perform a story as if it was a play? Okay, is it A, act out, B, act up, or C, act on? Which phrasal verb means to perform a story as it were a play or as if it was a play? Act out, act up, act on. Tahi, CCC is very positive that it's act on. MD Lighton, also very confident. Kien says act up. Ooh, difficult question, says Santiago ZC, but he thinks it's A. A from Nanda. Okay. And act on from Hello World. Hello, hello world. All right then. So have a guess. Okay. And we're going to move on to question number eight. Question number eight is the last quiz question in this BBC Learning English Live Friday quiz. And then we're going to do the answers. So stick around for the answers. Okay. They're coming up. So round eight. Round eight's question is about the definite and the indefinite article, which is a really important piece of English. It's really important to know this, and students find it quite tricky. So let's go to the cinema to watch film you were talking about. Is it to watch a film you were talking about, to watch the film you were talking about, or is it nothing, to watch film? X means no gap. Let's go to the cinema to watch film you were talking about. So is it A, B, or C, nothing? And let's take a look at what you are thinking in the comment section here. So we got a bit of a variety. Oop. Nora says B, the film. Zulfika, sorry if I'm not quite saying your name quite correctly. It says X, a film, says Santiago. Okay. Zulfika again, so BBB, please mention me. All right then. So a little bit of a variety here, and I think that reflects the fact that it is quite difficult to know when to use A or when to use the or when to have nothing and to just go straight into the noun. Okay. So, ding, 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 ding. I got, woo. That is the end of the questions. Answers coming up now. So this is the important part coming up. Okay, so don't go anywhere. we're going to be looking at the answer to these questions. If you have joined us late and you didn't put in your answer first time, now is the perfect time to do it. Okay, so you can still take part even if you joined late. So round one of the BBC Learning English live quiz was an idiom question. And we love idioms. And you can find lots of idioms. We put them out on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, at bbclearningenglish.com. Nearly every week, all the time, lots and lots of idioms. But which idiom means good luck for actors? Okay, it's quite strange, really, isn't it? All of these are quite strange choices. But what is it? Let's take a look at what you think. We got, yes, Alex says break a leg. Vero says break a leg. Lulu, break a leg. So lots and lots and lots of you saying break a leg. And let's check, is that the correct answer? Whoop, whoop. Yes, it is. Break a leg. Okay, so break a leg is an idiom which means good luck for actors and stage performers. Before you go on stage or before you start filming, you can say break a leg to wish them good luck in the show. Now, there's a few different theories on why we use this term, but there's one I particularly like. It is said, okay, this is one theory, is that hundreds of years ago, at the end of a show, you'd pick up your chair and you'd bang it if you liked it. The more you liked it, the harder you would bang, 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 bang. So if you liked the show, sometimes the legs of the chair would break. So that meant it was a particularly good show. So actors would wish each other to have a great show by saying, break a leg. So did you get that correct? Very good question from Renu. Says, do you say it in other occasions too? Not really. It's mostly used for acting situations, theatre, stage or movies. But we might say break a leg in other situations, but kind of reflecting back because we know it's mostly for the stage. So we can use it if we want to, but it's mostly for acting situations. Okay. Kudi, one out of one. Perfect start. Let's keep it going. All right. Question number two. This was our grammar question. Now, what is the best film you... Now, what is the answer? Is it have ever seen, have ever seen, or I have seen? What do you think it is? What is the best film you have ever seen, have ever seen, or I have seen? And again, we've got Tahir says A, Shoheb, have ever seen, B from Federica. Okay. So this is a really important one to learn. And it's have ever seen. Okay, so this is the present perfect. And we use it with ever or never to talk about things that we have done at some point in the past. Now, it's especially useful for asking questions, especially if you just met somebody. So you can ask them, what is the best film you have ever seen? Or what is the best book you have ever read? Or you can say, where is the hottest country you have ever been? So we got the subject, have, ever, and past participle. Okay. And that will make a nice question about somebody's past. What have they done in their lifetime? So well done if you've got that right. And you can ask me a question using this format if you like. So we've got Casey Smiley Show saying 2 out of 8. Hello, world. You got this. 2 out of 8. Well done. Jasim, 2 out of 8. Okay. 2 out of 2. Ray, 2 out of 2. So great. Okay. Good job, everybody. Okay. So let's move on to round 3. Okay. So let me know how you're doing so far. I'm going to move on to question number 3 of the BBC Learning English Live Friday quiz. If you've just joined us, feel free to join in. Let us know your guesses. because we can go through the answers and guesses again. So we got a bit of a vocabulary question. And it's looking at, what do we call films which are very scary? Now, we've got lots of vocabulary activities on bbclearnenglish.com, and we've got it on our Facebook, YouTube. So check it out after the show. Okay, we've got lots of vocabulary for you to improve. But what is this key word here? So what do we call films which are very scary? Zainab, very confident. C. Raphael, horror. We got some people saying A, scarer. And we got Nagoyan saying horror as well. Okay, so Jilek says C, horror. So I think most of you got this right. In that, yes, it is, of course, a horror film. So we've got different types of film, which we call genres. And in this question, we looked at films that are very scary or terrifying or make you watch like this. Yeah. So horror, we call scary films horror films. Horror is a noun, which means an intense feeling of fear or shock or disgust. And if it sums up that feeling you get when you watch these horrible horror films. Do you have a favorite horror film? I liked Candyman. That was my favorite. Do you have a favorite horror film? Let's have a look in the comment section. Charis Chang has got them all right so far. Vero says, three, I don't like horror films. I'm not a big fan either, to be honest. We've got, a good question. I'm going to try and find the good question here. Okay. What is a scarer? So, it's a good question. There is no type of film called scarer. It's something I've made up as a trick question to see if you might say it. So you're not watching a scarer. There's no such thing. A thriller is a very exciting movie where there's lots of actions and it raises your heart and you're engaged, but its main goal is not to make you scared or fearful. Okay, there's not lots of jumps with ghosts and monsters and zombies. It's more of a quick-paced, fun film following the adventure of somebody. That's a thriller. Okay. Elham saying, I'm not being mentioned. Ooh-hoo-hoo. You are now. Hello, Elham. Hi from the UK. Okay. Let's have a look. And we got Nagoyet says, I like horror films, although I nearly cry in the cinema. I know the feeling. I'm not a huge fan myself. Okay. So let's have a look. So Shripping says, a heart-beating movie, that's the thriller. Yeah. So some of you are asking, what's the difference between a thriller and a horror? A thriller is more exciting and how can I describe a thriller? So we'll start with a horror movie. Okay, horror is exciting. It often has monsters or ghosts or zombies or somebody who's very horrible killing people. Okay, and its aim is to make you scared or to jump. Whereas a thriller is normally to do with crime or it's got an exciting storyline. Okay, it's exciting, not scary. It thrills you. Okay. Question number 4 of the BBC Learning English Live quiz. Aha. And this is a great, if I do say so myself, this is a great question because so many students find this difficult. Okay. And it's something we need to learn because we use it all the time. Okay. So the next episode of my favorite show comes out Wednesday. Comes out at Wednesday, on Wednesday, in Wednesday. What do you think? We've got on from Fatima. Carol also says on. Shoaib says on. Lots and lots of you. We got Intan saying see. 18 mice saying A, at. But the correct answer, as most of you correctly guessed, was on. So, the answer is on, with specific dates or days we use on. For example, I was born on the 1st of May. So one specific day on. Or days of the week. I will meet you on Monday. Let's go to the cinema on Tuesday. Let's have a party on Friday. So the next episode of my favorite show comes out on Wednesday. Now, we use on for special holiday days as well. So I had a great party on New Year's Eve, or I went to get lots of presents on my birthday, or I had dinner with my family on Christmas Day. So we use on for days of the week or specific dates, or for special holiday days like Christmas Day or your birthday, New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. So that is four. We're halfway through the quiz. How are you doing? How many have you got so far? Okay, so MD Lighton says, I'm always confused about prepositions. It is tricky, but we've got some great episodes on 6-minute grammar. At the end of the show, I'm going to put a link, so stick around, everybody. I'll put a nice link to more content based on all the questions here. So if you didn't get the question right, you can go and do more research. So MD Lighton, stick around, and I'll put a link at the end because I think it's Sam does a very nice English in a minute that explains it very clearly. Okay, so prepositions are tough. So we've got Manel has got 3 out of 4. Good job, not bad at all. We've got Jan, 4 out of 4. Oops, let me have a look. I found a nice example here. This is Badrapriya. Badrapriya has given a nice example here. So we say at 5 a.m. for a time, on Monday for the day of the week, in January for the month. So very well explained. Great example. I love it. And Shuping says on for specific days and days of the week. Exactly that. So well done. We've got Wahid, 4 to 4. Whew, we are halfway. You guys are rocking this. You're doing very, very well. Question 5. This was Shan's question. Let me get a quick drink because I've got a frog in my throat. So at an awards ceremony, the VIPs, the very important people, and the stars and the celebrities and the actors walk down A, the red carpet. So it's this here. B, the red path. Or C, the red line. What do you think this could be? Adeni says red carpet. Ray Jang says A, red carpet. We've got everybody here is saying red carpet. So it seems we're very confident, so we'll move on. Yes, the answer is red carpet. So before an award ceremony or somewhere important, when you've got royalty or celebrities, they might walk down the red carpet. Now, if you haven't seen it, this week on the BBC Learning English News Review, Neil and Tom looked at the 2021 Golden Globe Awards and taught you some words related to that. Red carpet was one of them. I'll share the link after the quiz. You can go and check it out. It's a really nice lesson. News Review, BBC Learning English. It's really good. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. It's on there as well. So the red carpet, long, narrow red carpet, is put on the ground for an important visitor to walk upon when they arrive somewhere. If you have someone important come to visit you, like the CEO of the company, you can say, we are going to roll out the red carpet, which means it's an idiom, meaning that we're going to give a very special welcome to an important or special guest. Did you get that correct? Intan is 4 out of 8, doing good. Cootie, 5 out of 5 so far. Okay. All right. Okay. So good, good, good. Round six was the Samuel L. Jackson round with a nice quote. Okay. He said, I'm always for an audience. I'm always look for an audience. I'm always looked or I'm always looking. What do you think? I'm always look. I'm always looked or I'm always looking. Tahi says, see. Sorry, can't pronounce your name, but we've got a C here. Okay, and we've got lots of you saying look. Few people saying look. Few saying looked, but most people saying looking. Okay, so the answer is, of course, I'm always looking for an audience. And this we use always with the present continuous to describe a common trait or behavior. So for example, my friend is always playing on his phone when I'm trying to talk to him. Or my best friend Zainab is always talking during class. So we use always plus the present continuous to say, describe someone's common behavior. Can you give me an example of yourself or a friend who is always doing something? So we got Anil, 5 out of 6. Srepov is asking, why is not look? So we use always, okay, I, be, always, and present continuous, okay, to describe a common behavior that we do all the time or quite frequently, okay? So I'm always looking for a good book to read. So that means that when, like, day to day, I'm always thinking about, I'm looking for a nice book. So we don't use look because we need to use I'm always present continuous here. Okay. Question number 7. 2 more to go, so stick around. Okay, BBC Learn English Live Friday quiz. Oh, before we do, we've got some nice examples here. Okay. Oh, Mima, I'm always asking for help whenever I need it. Yeah, okay. I'm always asking for help. It's a lovely, lovely example. And you, U-turns, I'm always looking for ways to help people. Fantastic. And Heaven, I'm always looking for my socks. I know the feeling. I know the feeling. Okay. All right then. So lovely examples from everybody. I'm really happy with that. Ray's got, I'm always doing my work while browsing the internet. I'm familiar with that situation as well. And Noemia has said, my friend is always looking for a job. Well, I wish them good luck in finding that job. And Amnesia soon, similar. Good luck in finding that job. It's a tough year. Good luck with it. Okay. Round 7. Which phrasal verb means to perform a story as if it were a play? Okay. Which phrasal verb means to perform a story as it were a play or as if it was a... as if it were a play. Yeah. Sherping, lovely example from question 6. Going back to question 6. But let's take a look here. We got 7. Act on from Chan Vyasna. We got act on from Lin Xuan. Some of you might have had a quick look at the answer, so you might have a little hint there. Okay. We got Aline says, act out, act up. So this one I think was a little bit tricky. I think a few of you found this a little bit difficult because we've got a lot of variety of questions here. Okay, and the correct answer is... okay, we got it. I got there in the end. Is act out. So, excuse me. Act out is a phrasal verb, which means to act out a story as if you were in a play. So, for example, the drama students acted out the storyline so that their friends could imagine the show a bit more clearly. Okay, and it means that you use hand gestures and maybe, I happen over here, and maybe some props to make the story a bit more clear. So act out is the phrasal verb. If you are looking to learn phrasal verbs, be sure to check us out, bbclearnenglish.com, on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Every Friday morning, we've got a lovely phrasal verb tables, 5 new ones every week, and it's a really nice way of slowly getting more and more phrasal verbs so that you've got a nice back catalogue of phrasal verbs that you can use. Okay. Maria, no worries, Maria. Okay, there's still another question for you to have a go at, and we're here to learn. Okay. Yilin also says, number 7 is tricky, but you got it right. Well done. Raphael says, 7 out of 7, perfect so far. Good job. Okay. And we've got, there are thousands of them. Yes, there are many, many phrasal verbs. Okay. But we're going to do, like I said, check us out on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Every Friday morning, we've got 5 there. Okay. And if you, it's a really nice way to just slowly build up. You don't want to learn too many at once. So a few a week. And you can just build it up so that you're building your vocabulary. It's a really nice way. Okay. Okay. So Tahir has asked a nice question. Okay. What is the differentiate between these three, please? No problem, Tahir. So act out. And phrasal verbs have many meanings often. So I will just give you one example from each. Act out is to perform. So you perform a little story and you use hand gestures and body language and maybe your voice and a prop to tell a story. Act out. To act up. Act up, in one of the meanings of act up, is to misbehave. So my, let's give an example of my child acted up in front of his friends. He's usually very nice, but he was very naughty and talkative when his friends were around. So it's misbehave, and act on is to take action. So my friend gave me a tip. My friend gave me a recommendation that this new movie was great. So I acted on his advice and went to the cinema to watch it. So it's to take decisive action. Okay, Tahir, I hope that helps. Okay. All right, then let's move on to question 8. Question 8 was this. Okay, and how are you doing? I haven't heard anybody say how many you've got so far. So tell me, how many have you got so far? Oops, and Shinny has asked where to get the worksheet. There is no worksheet, but in a few minutes, when we finish, I'm going to give a link to a lesson for each question. So for each of these questions, I'll give a link where the BBC Learning English team will explain to you why and how to do this in a bit more detail, because we're going a little bit fast today. Because it's a quiz. It's a fun quiz, right? So Johnny says, B, the. We've got Aline says, A. Mashid said the film, and yeah, lots of those and lots of A. Not many people saying nothing. So here we go. So this is the answer. The correct answer is the. We use the definite article the when we are talking about one particular thing. So we are talking about one particular film. So we're talking about the film which you had mentioned or discussed or talked about before. We're talking about that film, the one you were talking about. We use A when we are thinking of a choice. Let's watch a film. Okay, and that means any film. We haven't really decided yet, but we're talking about one specific particular film, so we should use the. Najat is saying A because we haven't defined the film mentioned. Okay, actually, we have. We're talking about the specific film that we talked about last week. So the film we were talking about, that one film we were talking about, we talk about that one particular film. So we should use the definite article the. Same as Ray Jang saying it refers to a specific film. Yes, it does. Okay. So let me know how many you got right. Okay, so that's 8 questions. How many did you get right today? Congratulations to everybody for getting through the quiz. As we said, as I say every week, doing a quiz in a second language is quite tough. Yeah, so well done on getting through to the end, of watching it all, of trying, for giving your comments, for getting involved. Really proud of you. If you enjoyed, please hit that like button. Okay, like, comment, please share. Let me know how many you got correct. Okay, and remember, it's not a competition. We're all at different stages of our learning, all at different levels. We just want to improve. So if you got 6 right, 6 out of 8 this week, next week, try for 7 out of 8. If you got 7 out of 8, try for 8. If you got 3 or 4, okay, make sure that you go to bbclearningenglish.com, check us out, and go to our Facebook, Twitter, Instagram pages, go to YouTube, obviously, and we've got lots of content there that will help you. Lots of the questions are based on things we do during the week, so if you watch during the week, if you follow and subscribe, it will be a big help, and you'll get a little bit more out of the quiz. So, whatever your score, aim to do the same thing or better next week. Let me have a look. Raphael says, have a nice weekend, everybody. Raphael, you too. Amalia, 6 out of 8. Good job. Okay, Akash says, bye-bye. Do says, your class is more interesting than my class in school. Good. I hope so. I hope that this fun BBC Learning English quiz is a little bit more interesting than a class in school. So I'm glad to hear it. Thank you very much for that. Okay. Manal, thanks. See you next week. And Yilin, same for you. Dr. Fahad, bye. Okay, hope to see you next week. Naya, thank you too. All right then. Thoy Tham, thanks for joining us. And Nora's come up with the most important question of all. We will be back, or I will be back, next Friday at 1:30 UK time on Facebook and YouTube. So Fridays, 1:30 p.m. UK time, Facebook and YouTube. See you next week. Okay. Ray Jang. So next week, we're going to start. I'm just checking the levels, okay? Lots of people with lots of getting 6, 7, 8. So next week, I'm going to put in a few more trickier questions, okay, to challenge people. Too many people are getting 8 out of 8. So there'll be a few tricky ones next week, so please come back for those. All right. Thanks. Thank you, guys. All right. Bye.